Hello, hello, mic test. It's raining heavily outside, so yeah, it's a good vibe for coding today. Perfect. So we have any information of all these mutual funds which are randomly selected. These are the columns, these are the column headers, and here we have all the information of it. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritwik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're here to learn how to do analysis on mutual funds in India, then you're at the right place. In this video, I'll be using a Python package called MFtool to extract the information of mutual funds in Python, and then we'll do some basic analysis. We'll set a context for the next video where we'll be making a detailed dashboard of mutual funds in India. And yes, it is free of cost. Before writing the code, guys, if you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to making trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, making some great trading strategies, etc., etc. So if this is something that you're interested in, then click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos that are about to come on this YouTube channel. And I bet you that this one free click is going to increase your skill sets significantly. Perfect. So let's see what are the topics that we are going to cover in this video. As I mentioned, I will be referring to the Python package called MFtool. So in the beginning, we'll go through its documentation. We'll see how to install this particular package on Python. We'll refer to the MFI India website, where we'll be sourcing the scheme codes to extract the financial information of all the mutual funds in India. We'll explore all the useful functions of this Python package. And in the end, we'll set a context of how we'll be using it in the next video to make a proper full-fledged dashboard of mutual funds. I'm using Google Colab for writing this code. You guys can use JupyterLab or any other platforms as well. So yes, guys, this is the documentation of MFtool. The link is in the description section. As it says, MFtool is a library for getting the publicly available real-time mutual funds data in India. It can be used in various types of projects which requires getting live codes for the given scheme or build large data sets for further data analysis. Perfect. What are the main features? Getting the last updated code prices of the mutual fund schemes in the form of data frame, JSON, dictionary, etc. Schemes which are available on the MFI, which is Association of Mutual Funds of India. This is how we'll be installing the Python package, which is simple pip install MFtool. And this is the entire documentation, which definitely we will cover in much detail in this video itself. You guys can refer to the GitHub link as well for this Python package. Again, the link is in the description section. Last thing, I was referring to the MFI India website, which is Association of Mutual Funds in India. It is responsible for all the mutual fund related activities in India. And if we go to this link, again, this link is in the description section, you'll get an information of all the mutual funds which are registered in India under MFI. And we have information like scheme code, ISIN growth, if available, scheme name, net asset value, and date, right? So over here, you can see all this information is in the same format. The most important thing here is basically the date, the net asset value, and the scheme name, right? And in order to get all this information, we'll be referring to the scheme code. Today, I'm recording this video on 16th of November. So the last traded price was on 14th of November. Perfect. So let's start with installing this Python package, which is pip install mftool. We'll run it. I have already installed it in my system. So yeah, it is already satisfied. In your case, it would be downloading this package and installing. The first thing that we'll do is from mftool, we will import mftool. Now let's see what are different functions which are available in this. So help, and I'll just copy and paste it here. It will give me a detailed information about all the things which are available inside it. Things like calculate balance units value, calculate return, AMC profile, all available schemes, average AUM. The thing which is important for us, the most important thing is basically this thing, which is scheme historical NAV for dates, scheme historical NAV, scheme info is important, scheme quote is important, history is important, and yeah. So we will explore all these functions, all the important functions only in this video, one by one. The first thing that I'll do is basically MF is equal to MFtool, and that's it. Let's see what is MF. It should be an object which will be using it to extract the information of mutual funds. Yeah. Now, let's start using all these functions one by one. The most important and the first thing actually would be to get a list of all the available mutual funds which are registered under AMFI, these things in Python. So what I'll do here is basically I'll be using this function called all scheme codes is equal to mf.get scheme codes, right? It is automatically recommending me. And let's see what is it. So when we run it, we'll get the entire list of all these things, all the available mutual funds in India. Right, and it's a dictionary which we can definitely use for some, I would say, for referring to some other place. Definitely we'll be using it in the next video while we make the dashboard. Right, so what do we have? We have scheme code and the scheme name. For example, Aditya Birla Sun Life Banking and PSU, regular IDCW is this one. If we search, say, ICICI Prudential mutual funds, we have this list of all these mutual funds. Right, so what I'm concerned about is to use this particular thing everywhere, because MFtool Python package is dependent on this identifier. This is always same. If I'm unable to find that scheme code, then in that case, I can search it as well. I'll be using this get available schemes, and I just provided a keyword, which is ICICI. I want all the scheme codes of ICICI. So these are all the mutual funds available for ICICI that we can refer. So suppose scheme code is equal to, I'll pick one of them, say this one, I picked it from here, and I would like to get detailed information about this mutual fund. So I'll use this function, which is mf.get scheme details and then the scheme code. If we write details here, we'll get a detailed information about this particular mutual fund, which is the fund houses ICICI Prudential Mutual Funds. It's an open-ended scheme. Category is other scheme index fund, which is basically the name is ICICI Prudential Nifty Mid Cap 150 Index, which is one of the funds that I picked from here. Direct plan growth, and the scheme start date was this date, which is basically the NFO date, right? New fund offering date, which is 23rd of December 2021. The current NAV is this. Pretty good function. We get most of the information that we want from any mutual fund with just one function itself. We can get the current NAV of the mutual fund through this function as well, which is get scheme code. And then the scheme code, if I just write Q here, we'll get scheme code, which is the thing that we passed, the name, the last traded date, and the last traded price, which is NAV as of now. Before moving to the historical NAVs of all the mutual funds, guys, if you're struggling with coding in Python programming, then I have a great news for you. I have built a proper course for Python for financial programming. If you want to learn only the things which are useful in the field of finance, in Python, then this is something for you. I also learned Python with time, and now I can see that I would say 99% of the things available on Python are of no use for people in finance, and that's why I created this particular course to cover that 1% segment, such that by learning that you can get a very good understanding of Python programming and can use it for your personal and professional lives. Just go to this website, which is fpritvik.com/python. Select one of the buttons here. Again, the link is in the description section. This will redirect you to the course page. Thankfully, we still have the Diwali offer running on the course. You'll get a 70% instant discount if you enroll right now. Scroll down, you'll have a detailed information about this course. There are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, many assignments and quizzes. And in the end, there are 2 live projects on stock analysis and investment portfolio creation. This is where you can see a detailed syllabus of the course. So yes, again, guys, use the code Diwali to get a 70% instant discount. And don't wait more, because this offer will be taken away very soon. Okay, let's come back to our code. Okay, perfect. So how to get the historical information of NAVs of mutual funds? I'll use this function, which is basically historical get scheme historical NAV, and then the scheme code is the one that I provided here as data frame is equal to true. If we just write it like this, we'll get the historical NAVs for this particular scheme. We can place with some of the things here. So basically what I'll do here is I will pick some of the scheme codes here. I want NAV for all the mutual funds in just one data frame itself. So what I'll do here is I'll just write for, first thing is I'll just make a list of all these scheme codes. Let's start with this one, comma. Let's pick these things. We'll copy this. Perfect. These are some of the scheme codes that I selected randomly. Let's do one thing. For I in range of these things, I want historical data. I'll just copy this, paste it here. Historical data is equal to mf dot this thing, and I want what I can do is I can actually remove the range. I'll do one thing, which is I'll replace this with I and do it like this. I want only the NAV and not the day change. So let me just introduce one more data frame here. Before that, I'll have to import pandas as pd. And a df1 is equal to pd.dataframe, right? Here we'll just write df1, and the name, which is I'll just write 1 for now, is equal to historical data. Inside this, only the NAV column. Now, rather than this, I want the name of the fund, right? The name of the fund comes from this function, which is get scheme details. I'll just write name is equal to mf dot get scheme details, scheme code, and this one I'll replace it with I, because these are all the scheme codes that we are putting in just one list. The name is here, which is scheme name, which is automatically I think suggested by Google Colab. Right now what I'll do here is I'll just write name as a column header and provide all the NAVs here. I think that's it. Let's see if we have all the information in just one data frame. I think we have it. It's raining heavily outside, so yeah, it's a good vibe for coding today. Perfect. So we have any information of all these mutual funds which are randomly selected. These are the columns, these are the column headers, and here we have all the information of NAVs. Again guys, if you're finding any difficulties, I have dedicated chapters on pandas in the course, so yeah, that would be very helpful. The last thing here is to get the average AUM. So I'll just write AVAUM is equal to this, which is mf dot get average AUM. We just need to provide the quarter, which is from July to September 2024, for example, right? And if we just write it like this, it will give me a list of all the mutual funds, fund houses in India with the total AUM inside it, right? And they have split it into two different segments, AUM overseas and AUM domestic. Again, it's a very good information. Cool. I think that's it for this video. I don't want to make it more complicated. I'll be using these all these functions in the next video, where we'll be making a proper detailed dashboard using Streamlit on mutual funds and how to track mutual funds on a personal level. You don't need to refer to any websites to track your mutual fund investments. If you're facing any difficulties in writing this code, guys, it's absolutely fine. I'll save this particular code on my Google Drive. If you're already a member of my Google Drive community, you will find it over there. If you're not a member yet, just go to my channel and click on this particular link, which is on the right side of my profile photo. This will redirect you to a YouTube community post. Just follow these steps to become a Google Drive community member. It's highly affordable. I charge hardly anything on this community. Because I have hired a couple of interns and I just need to pay salary to them. Otherwise, it's absolutely worth it. The type of content that I have put over there is 100% worth it. So yes, please check it out. If you liked even one thing about this video, guys, please click on the like button. It really helps with the algorithm. And also hit on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. There are many more videos that are about to come on this YouTube channel, and your support by subscribing to my YouTube channel means a lot to me. For freelancing inquiries, please write to us on this particular email address and someone from my team will reach out to you as soon as possible. So yes, stay tuned for the next video on a full-fledged dashboard of mutual funds. Thank you so much guys for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there you'll see this playlist of extracting stocks information in Python and Excel, and over there you'll see this video on how I build an MT5 trading bot in just less than 1 hour. So yes, keep learning, keep financial programming, and I'll see you very, very soon in the next video, next Saturday. Until then, peace.